Okay, A20 NFT currently at how many kilometers? Weep. Under 59,000 kilometers. I'm very curious to see. Has oil inside the engine? Have a reason why I'm asking. Alright. 1 second to grab a rag to clean it up. Just a second. Alright, clean dipstick. Let's put it in. Yeah, I knew it. I knew it. It came here, the car, I don't know, 3 or 4 times up to now, just for checking the car, but and comes all the time without oil. I don't know how long it's inside the oil. Anyhow, we fix piece connections, we rebuild the, engine, and you're not changing the oil. All right. Okay. Let's see what we have. I'm gonna check also inside the cylinders, just in case. I wanna see. It's working, it's starting. Let me start the car. It's fine, it's not smoking, it doesn't make any weird sound or something or whatever. Just let me start it. Let me start the car. Keep this there. The only thing what you hear, it's normal. The charcoal canister solenoid, that's make the tick, 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 when it comes to the burst temperature, and that's it. And a little bit the injectors and the high pressure pump. Not something crazy. All right, let's fire it up. Take care about the oil. Take care about the oil. How many times? How many times? Alright, no check engine, no nothing. That's a good one. They see soon, probably. No, it's off. So why is it running the fan? Let me turn it off to see. There is a coolant inside or what? Yes, there is. There is a coolant. Okay. Have to put also the diagnostic to see why it's running the radiator fan. Okay. Let's see inside, see what's going on. What in hell is sand? Is this sand inside or what? And the smell, it's not smelling very good. Anyhow. Let's have a look on it. See what's going on. Looks like that when he changed the filter last time, I don't know. Yep. Lifting up the car, putting on the jack, raising it up, check from down, check inside the on the cylinders, and getting also compression. Let's see, let's have a look. I have a reason why I'm saying that, because when you have a positive pressure inside of the crankcase, it starts leaking oil everywhere. and to have a pressure inside of the crankcase, either you have run out on the cylinders, let us say, or you have slightly melt piston if you like, or you have a problem with the anyhow, let's see. Okay, car is on the jack. 1 second, just let me set the light. Let's see from here it is wet, if you like, it's stuck sand on it. This can be even from the oil filter. That means when you're opening the oil filter, it can have some drops here, because it's not a live leak. You don't see wet, it's stuck the sand on it. That's how it looks like here. That was leaking before, and they put at the beginning full of sealant. It doesn't leak, that's nice all the way around on the oil pan. It looks nice here. There is one wet mark. It looks like it's coming from up and up there inside. Where's the water pump? And see on this bolt, it's wet. There. Okay. It looks like, yeah, there. This is an oil leak from the water pump. And then the timing cover on the side, it comes a gasket. I don't see. Yeah, it looks like it's okay. So it's has one minor leak, let's say, from the water pump. Here it looks okay. Return. There has on this pipe for the water pump has some gases on it, but it does look like it's leaking from the gasket. I don't know if it's broken, if it has a crack, if the headers has a crack over there. That's a different story. Also up, nah, he burned the gasket of the downpipe. Yeah. That's why. The gasket of the downpipe over there, it's burnt. This is what gasket it came with, same like this. Same gasket like this came with the downpipe. In my opinion, it's supposed to be metallic and not this type of gasket for the exhaust. Engine mounts are gone. This is tired, the front one, but the rear one looks like it's been broken completely. Morning, Omar.
Morning.
Nice day for fishing, ain't it? All right, let's have a look here. What's happening with the bushes? All right. Why I remember that there was a cover here? Maybe I'm wrong. I think there was a cover, anyhow. Omar, yes, guess what?
Well, you come back, huh?
Yeah, there's no oil inside.
Again?
Yeah, again, all the time.
Then you're blaming us, huh?
Huh?
Then they're blaming us, huh?
Yeah, but the first day that he bring it for a filter downpipe, he melted a piston here outside, you remember? Yeah, it came without that. Even with 1 liter of oil, 2 liters of oil, how much? Yeah, now again, it's not grabbing the dipstick oil at all. How many times? Every time he has come here, how many? Two or three times?
More.
Three times?
Yeah.
All the time that's coming here, there's no oil.
And when the car is manual, it's like more than 7,000 kilometers.
This is different. If you are using inside of the city, and it's a manual, and you are not changing also the oil. What the fuck? Okay, Omar, what I want from you, when they stop these guys, I'm gonna say, I need all four spark plugs out, okay. All right, there is a minor leak, 1 second to stop these guys. Okay, listen up, that's the story. There is a minor leak from the water pump over there, you see one bolt that's leaking?
Yeah, I can see it.
There is a bolt over there that's leaking, and there is the gasket for the downpipe, the upper one, it's been burned,
okay?
So, these two things, it's from down. Then, we need to count how much oil has the engine inside.
Okay, he wanted to
go. Yeah. No, I don't know if he wants to change the oil or not. Mm. All right? But removing the bar, to don't start spreading the oil left and right, because most probably whoever changed it, he didn't remove the bar, probably, all right? Open the drain plug, and I want to count exactly even the last drop of the oil to see how many liters has inside. Then I need spark plugs out, compression test, battery charger, compression test, and I'm gonna bring also the camera to have a look inside the cylinders, how it looks like. Now that we have a new camera and it's much more clear, let us say, I wanna see on the side and down the piston. All right, that's it for now. I want to see also how many kilometers has that time when he came. Yeah, I have it. I'm going to check it now. No, it doesn't matter. And here also this screw for the air filter. It's on the air. Check also the air filter, which condition is. What is the condition of the filter? Yeah, no worries. Coolant, I already checked. Has coolant inside. It's fine. There's no problem with the coolant. I'm opening from one side and it's staying from the other side. Hey, how nice. Okay. All right. Whatever. I remember something on this, what I did before, there is a step here, I put a new seal and there is a step here between the upper cover and the lower cover, so it's not closed completely. So what I did, because there was a leak from the cover, I eat 3 tons of millimeter from this step to be more squeezed down. Obviously with a new gasket to stop having a leak. This, I was doing this also on the Peugeot Citroën, the 16 valve, the cover, back in Greece. You can eat completely actually, but it's gonna come much more down. I don't know if on this one it's fine. Alright. I'm curious to see inside what's going on. The condition of the spark plugs and the condition of the pistons and the cylinders. Let me have a look. How many kilometers has when it came the car here? Some info for the Opel. We released the car November 2019, 1.5 year ago, at 120,000 kilometers. Now it has 159, almost 40,000 kilometers later. Just to put it on the video to know what's going on. Anyhow, it looks like the engine that it drove for 1 million kilometers, but anyhow, yeah. Let's have a look. Let's see what's going on with the compression and with the camera. The filter is okay.
Yeah. It's closed now.
Need cleaning. We need to clean the filter. What's the filter? Where are the spark plugs?
Ma.
Where you put the spark plugs?
We clean wash last time.
Yeah. Okay, you have to wash it again. Doesn't matter because you washed the last time. That means you're gonna be washed for everywhere. Yeah. You keep the spark plugs out. What did I say? I said because you washed the last time, you're not gonna stay forever clean. Yeah. I don't remember what I said. Anyhow, let's see the spark plugs. There you go. Whoops. Okay. Hey, it's consuming some oil, eh? Oh boy. Yep. Yep. It's not a clean burn. Alright, let's bring the camera, put the battery charger to get a compression test. right? Instead of putting the negative, the stamp, let us say somewhere here to be able to visible to see, they hide it. Whee! All right. So I'm bringing the compression test, the cage, and the camera. Yes, coming back. Okay, ready? Crank. Again, continue again. Okay. Okay. Empty. Yeah, bleed it. We're gonna have this is number one. All right. Has a leak. Has a leak to the cage. 11 and a half you gonna reach also this one. No, it's fine. Make it again. Yeah, 11 and a half, like the first one. Okay, all right. Jump to the third one. Go for it. Again. A little bit better the cylinder. Okay. Go to number four. Okay. Number four is a little bit better. Again. Slightly better. Three and four slightly better than the number one, number two. Okay, let's bring the camera. And I'm putting now the camera inside the cylinder number one. What you see there? Detonations. What you see, 1 second. On the other side, I'm talking about there, this one, and here. These are detonations. I don't know, it's the fuel, what they're using, 95 RON or whatever. I don't know, intake temperature, something's wrong here. You can see it has pre-ignition the car, the engine. Let's see sideways the cylinder. It's not the best. You can see on top of the piston how it looks like from the pre-ignition or detonations. And this definitely the cylinder wall, it's not the best. And you can see how much soil consumption. Here. Yep. All right, let's go to number four, because the number two is supposed to be top dead center. This is the number two, and it's supposed to be up. Right? Come on, get inside. Yeah, let's go to number four. Number four. Why to have a coolant inside? These drops are supposed to be water. And the cylinder on number four is not in the best shape. What in here? We have a head gasket burnt or what? The video of this camera, because I'm recording it right now, will be at the end of this video. Omar! Bring the leak test for the cooling system. Bring it to put it in. I want to pressurize to see what's going on. Has a coolant inside, I said earlier. Dang it. He burned also the head gasket. You can tell me if you don't have an oil inside. The oil is not only for lubrication, it's also for cooling. Anyhow, okay, let me stop the camera until he brought the tools, and then we don't have it, don't have a video 3 days waiting, right? I'm pausing it as it is because I have now the spot here on the head gasket, and that's why I want to keep it there and make the pressure test to see what's going on, if it starts leaking inside. Okay, yes, I'm already recording from this camera. Pump, let's see, that has zero. Yeah, okay, pump up to 15 psi, not more than 15. Go for it. And what you see here, it's leaking inside the combustion chamber. And this is a head gasket. Remove the air, because we have to crank it after that to remove the water from the cylinder. We don't have any problem. Okay. There is any bar inside of the car? No. I'm gonna check also the number 2 and number 3.
Nothing's inside.
Okay. 1 second to lift up the camera. I'm on the side. 1 second to make it front. We are going to the number 2. Okay, Nufu! Crank it.
Slowly crank one
time. One tack only. One time.
One time. Slowly, move the brake.
Again, Nufu.
One time, remove the
one time, and we need to put the piece on the bottom of the sender.
No. Finish.
Ah, dang it. Once again.
Finish.
Again. It stays in the middle. No? Alright, finish. Finish, that's it. Come out.
Come on.
Don't touch anything, eh? I'm putting the camera in. Take a look, I make dirty the camera now. Much better. Yeah, same thing here. You can see at this point, and at this point, then let's see the cylinder wall. Not the best. Let's see the number 3 cylinder now. Same story here. And I think also here. Let me go to the sideway camera. Yeah, this is the engine that he broke also. Twice the spark plugs, right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So definitely there's a problem with the number 4 cylinder, where I'm pointing. Head gasket's leaking. And how in hell the coolant was okay? He had coolant probably? Maybe.
This number 4 cylinder, the pressure is good.
It's good because it has water inside, because the engine is not at operation temperature, it's not hot. And that's why it does have misfire. And that's why you see this is the number 4 cylinder, right?
Yeah.
Yep. Who knows? Maybe it's equalizing the pressure. The pressure that has the servo cylinder, the pressure that has the cooling system, it's enough, let us say, to keep it there. I don't know. Anyhow, yeah, that's it with the A20 NFT. You know what? Screw it. You know what I want to do? Shit, did I save it now or I lose the clip? God damn it. Instead of pressing this one. Okay, let me have a look on it to see. No. I lost the clip from the number 2 and number 3. You see? Dang it.
I do have a video.
Yeah, I don't remember if. Okay, we're gonna see. We're gonna figure it out this one. No worries. Yeah, at least I have it on this camera. Yeah. What I want to do now, what I was saying, shit, my mind. Ah, remove the bar, clean one bucket, the blue one, the small one, clean it, make it nice and clean and dry with the petrol, you know, and collect the oil. I want to see how much oil it has inside the engine. Okay, you didn't touch the drain plug, right?
No.
Very good. Open it. Open it to see how much oil it has inside. From the day number one when he came here, we are screaming for the engine oil.
Not only with him, everyone.
And we are saying also use the super, not the special. Super is 98 RON, special is 95. Anyhow, we don't know. Yeah. And there is a blow by since the cylinder walls are in this condition. Definitely there is a blow by and there is a presence of the crankcase. That's the reason why it was startling from everywhere. Yeah. Tell me about it.
Malu.
Yeah.
Malu.
The orange stay there, you see? Alright, yeah, the no, it's okay. Do we have any empty can, 1 liter can from there? Any bottle? Yeah. You see how it became the oil from blow by? We don't know also how many kilometers has inside. What? He's putting 5W30 he's putting inside? Dang it! That's not a 10W60. This definitely is not 10W60. Has 3 liters has inside, fortunately. Fortunately, it is what it is, right? It doesn't matter. You're not gonna change the fact that he has a burn head gasket and the cylinders are. There are. Never mind. Never mind. Give me the light, 1 second. Leave it to remove the oil and then we can count it. Yeah, it's almost done, right? You saw how it looks like the head gasket from inside?
I love the color.
Which color? Of the oil?
The
feel it on your finger and you can see this is nothing to do with the 10W60. Most probably they put the 5W30 again inside. And the cross hats and the piston rings and the pistons, it's not for 5W30. Which one? Yeah, it's fine, start it, bring a little bit out to fix the handbrake cable, and that's it. After that, you can give it for washing, give it to BMC, back to the office to release the car. Okay, it doesn't make any sense now, it's already, it's drained the most of the oil. Just, where do you put the drain plug? Ah, bring the drain plug from there, it's over there. Just don't make a mess. All right. They didn't even change the oil. Looks like. Very sharp threads. Yeah, okay, all right. It is what it is. Now, okay, let's do it like this. That way. Let's go there. All right. Now, this one, we have to put it in a container to count it, right? Yep. Give me a second. Give me a second. The colors from blue by. You're gonna stop when you're gonna be on the ML here. This is 1 meter. Go for it. Stop there. Stop. Empty this oil now. Okay. Empty this bottle.
Can we throw this one, okay?
Yeah, throw it in the... throw it there. It gets 5.5 liters, I think, in total. All right.
No, how we can manage now?
Yeah, exactly. You should empty it from the other side because it's not very clear. Slowly, are you? Slowly, because you don't see nothing.
Okay.
It's there. Approximately here.
Yeah, okay, you see.
Take the funnel out just to see on the video. Yeah, it's fine. Throw it. Second liter. Has 3 to 4 liters inside. Doesn't make any sense to weigh the oil because it's more light on the than the water, you know, so it's not equal 1 liter to 1 kilogram. And this oil we cannot use it because when you open it, it feels some sand inside from the drain plug there, you know. I saw some pieces that was falling inside. Yeah, go more. I can see the lever. I can see from here. Go. Wait. Yeah, a little bit. Okay, screw it. This is the third one. I think it gets something between 5 and 6 liters.
Between 5 and 6 liters?
Yeah.
Not so, I can check the invoice.
Yeah, better check the invoice how much, because we gotta know how much we add. Put. It's not... Okay, stop, okay. Stop. This is the fourth liter.
And what do you have this one?
Okay,
this one?
Four. And there's nothing here, actually. How much is this one? 100 ml. Let us say another 300 on the oil filter.
I will check that nice.
And inside, let us say, now we empty 4, all right? Let us say that has inside 4.5 liters. Check how much oil we are changing usually from the invoice. That means it's missing at least 1 liter from inside. Check also the invoice to have a look. Let us say that this is 4.5 liters. If you calculate also the oil filter and little bit that has on the oil pan inside and the little bit that was there, 4.5. Let us say. When you're running low on oil, the low oil level, maybe it's enough, let us say, up to 2000 RPMs. When you're raising up the RPMs, and this car does have a variable oil pump, all right? When you're raising the RPMs, it's sucking much more oil and much faster from the oil pump. That's why, if you see the first video when I opened the engine, I changed the oil pump, the gears inside, because there was some scoring, some marks. Because again, at the beginning it was running low on oil and we are screaming from the day number one, have an eye on the oil, at least to have the oil level correct and don't keep the oil long inside. The turbocharger is a stock turbocharger and they're consuming some oil, these turbos. So if you put a turbo upgrade, one good turbo upgrade, you're not gonna have the same oil consumption. Anyhow, let's see now what you're gonna tell me, Omar. How much oil we are putting usually, and that's it probably. wait. Say that again.
7 liters.
7 liters of oil? Wait, don't give any information. There is a VIN number, there is a number plate. Fold it. The same invoice has also the customer. I just don't want to show you the informations, his informations. So it's like, valve control exhaust comes. Ah, this is when it failed the solenoid valve exhaust and intake that we changed it. Okay, so 7 liters of oil. That's how much it's getting. And we remove 4 liters plus another half, let us say, that's inside on the filter and the rest down. Shit, man. 2.5 liters of oil, man. Yeah.
Almost 3 liters.
Dang it. Okay, listen up now. What are we gonna do? Because we don't know the owner what he wants to do. Okay, close back everything again as it was.
Okay.
Clean a little bit the spark plugs.
Okay.
All right. Crank it before you put the spark plugs to empty the cylinder. Just don't have anything inside. Little bit brake cleaner just to evaporate. Put back again the spark plugs. We're gonna put some oil inside. Put NW60. Put liquid malt NW60.
Okay.
We're gonna waste this oil, and most probably he's not gonna pay even for the oil because we didn't get approved to make an oil change. That's a different story. Screw it. No worries. I'm gonna pay for it. Put oil inside. If they said to you anybody anything, Tassos told me to put an oil, all right? If the owner, he doesn't want to pay for the oil, we don't care. I'm gonna pay for it. Close everything, put the spark plugs, car out.
Okay?
And I'm gonna write in the job card what needs the car.
Do you have a job card?
Yeah, I'm gonna write in a paper and then I'm gonna give it at the office. Doesn't matter. What? Ah, okay. That's it.
Hello?
That's it, guys. That's the end. For the Opel, I don't know what they're gonna decide, what they want to do. It is what it is, right? When somebody says to you from the day number one, have an eye on the oil level. Don't leave it without oil. Use 10W60 oil, especially here in this country. Okay. At least it survived for 40,000 kilometers. Something is that, right? Something is that. Anyhow, thank you very much. It's not one thing, let us say, that can cause detonations or pre-ignitions or something, you know. It's a combination, let us say. Intake air temperature, example, you see the air filter, need to be washed, all right? And the most wear that has an engine, it's when you're starting, let us say, in the morning and it's cold, and when it's come the time to change the oil. The last kilometers that you need to change the oil, that the oil has been contaminated, especially on this engine that has also blow-by, there you have the most wear, you know. So when you are reaching at the point that you have how many kilometers and you know that the oil need to be replaced, it's much better, you know, to take it easy. So I'll give you this scenario. It's missing 2.5 liters of oil from the engine currently, all right? The air filter is not in the best shape, all right? Very fine. The car is manual. It's driven inside of the city. Fine up now? The spark plugs, they're not the proper type. Yes, we gap it, all right? But it's not one step colder what we need to put inside because we cannot find it here at least. All right, then I'm gonna tell you this. He put one time, let us say, special instead of super 95 RON. That it's not the best petrol, even the 98 is not the best petrol. You see, right? So, the combination of all these actions, it's causing this kind of stuff. Plus, the driving attitude. If you get, let us say, the car, even with an old oil inside, even with a garbage petrol, if it does have a load, you're not gonna have any problem.
Yeah.
You know the point? You're gonna be able to make a trip, let us say, if the oil level is okay, and you're just cruising around, not full boost, not pedal to the metal, let us say, not in the city, that I have said that again, this, it's not the first time that I'm saying that, I have mentioned that before, and I'm saying that also to the owner. I don't know if he remembers or not. So, by using the city, let us say, first, second, third gear, and then traffic light. First, second, third gear, and then traffic light. You get my point? And you are pushing a little bit or you're driving a little bit more aggressive, and the oil has, let us say, 5,000-6,000 kilometers inside. The turbocharger, it's a stock turbocharger that it's well known that it's burning oil. That's what you get.
Nothing else.
Yeah, nothing more or less. From a mechanical point, you know, I cannot cause me as a mechanic, as an air closed engine, right? I cannot cause detonations, what you saw inside. I cannot burn the head gasket on the number 4, you get my point? Even if I want to. This has to do with all these variables, that all of them, they have effect. You're gonna tell me, yes, the little bit dirty air filter will gonna have effect. You're gonna have effect with a combination of the old oil, the spark plugs, the rate of the spark plug, the fuel, all this, it matters. Anyhow, the exhaust gasket, the for the downpipe, yeah, okay, we're gonna need to be replaced because it's burnt, but this is a drop in the ocean. Anyhow, that's the end. Thank you. And just listen to this. And this car has a burnt head gasket. And has a score inside the cylinders. Go figure out. To who you gonna say that and who you gonna believe you, right? It's not smoking, at least now on idle, under, without load, right? Yeah, it's a cutless downpipe, that's why it's like that, and has some oil consumption, obviously, that's why it became black. And it's running like this, without misfire, on the number 4. It just runs. Go figure out. Not only that, I put a bed. The customer, he brought it because it has an oil leak. All right. You don't see nothing. It's nothing spooky. Dang it. Anyhow, that's it. 40,000 kilometers later, 1.5 year. Finish the story. Let's see what they want me to do now. It starts, even starting, see, what's this? It's a clutch. All right. Okay. You know, Omar, it's running like it's okay. You know, like everything's fine.
Really?
Yeah. It's not smoking. It does make a misfire or something. What?
Like original now, huh?
Even before, when I start in the morning and I put inside the garage, I did feel something. It was not saying, do you have any misfire or something?
After the temperature?
What?
After that, when he really reached the temperature?
Again, there was a coolant inside. He brought it from Dubai, right? He didn't brought it from...
I think he did live
in here. I don't know. Anyhow, he drove the car. From back in the bumper, you just only see black smoke from the on the tailpipes because it has a cutlass downpipe. That's it.
It's lucky, brother.
What is lucky, man? What lucky? Anyhow, now that's the end. Cylinder number 1. Oh boy. One second, let me start the camera here. Just a second. I'm putting now the camera inside the cylinder number 1. What you see there? Detonations. What you see? 1 second. The other side. I'm talking about there. This one. And here. These are detonations. It's the fuel, what they're using, 95 on or whatever, intake temperature, something's wrong here. You can see, that's the ignition pickup, the engine. Let's see sideways, the cylinder. It's not the best. You can can see on top of the piston how it looks like from the pre-ignitions or detonations. And this is definitely the cylinder wall, it's not the best. And you can see how much salt goes up here. Yep. Alright, let's go to number 4, because the number 2 is supposed to be top descender. This is the number 2 and supposed to be up. Right? Yeah. Let's go to number 4. Number 4. Why to have a coolant inside? This drop is supposed to be water. And the cylinder number 4 is not in the shape. Have a head gasket vent or what? The video of this camera, because I'm recording it right now, is going to be at the end of this video. Omar! Bring the leak test for the cooling system. Bring it to put it in.
You want to check it?
Yes, I want to pressurize, see what's going on. But there's a cooler inside, that's right over here. Bring it. Then also the head gasket. You can't tell me if you don't have an oil inside. The oil is not only for lubrication, it's also for cooling. Anyhow, okay, let me stop the camera until he drops the tools.